I want to give all praises and glory and honor to Yahweh, what Yahawashi, call Halayim, Yahweh, what Yahawashi, Barakata, Abba Hashem, Yahawashi, Raka, Kadash, Barakata. Much love and respect to you brothers out there doing the work of sincerity and truth. Double honor to the elders of Great Millstone. Alright, I'm going into a video tonight or a subject I wanted to speak on, and watching the GMS Dallas camp live video tonight. And one thing that got me thinking, and it was basically like a reminder, was the elder Manasazat made a comment about saying that, you know, brothers that are in, you know, camps, not to have the mindset that you're always just going to be, you know, holding the sign, or, you know, just standing there, you know, making sure everybody's fine, you know what I'm saying? You have to be built up into knowing how to be a leader or to lead, and start your own camp. You know, that, you know, bigger camps have enough people to start more camps within the city. You know, and the reason I want to do the video is because when he said that, I had a dream going on 2 years now, and a lot of stuff was going on during that time, even within the camp, you know, that I'm in. Back then, I had another brother there, but, you know, things happened, and, you know, he ended up, you know, going back into the world, or, you know, but before all that happened, man, in the dream, it was told to me that brothers were coming into town. So I didn't know that the brothers were already there. So I ended up going, like, to a hotel or something like that. But all the brothers were outside, just, standing up. You know, some brothers were sitting down, like if they were waiting. So I went up to some brothers and saluted them. I saw two brothers I recognized was the brother Zakaria from the GMS Dallas camp, and Kazak from Mississippi. And I remember Kazak was speaking, and he was saying, you know, and it was like a serious countenance, and what the message that was being said was that every brother, it was commanding every brother to pair up in twos. All right. And I left that dream, you know, that was the end of the dream. But, yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just is, like I said, when I heard Elder Manasazat say that, we're coming into a time where we're not always going to be together, as far as, like, if you have, you know, 20 brothers in your camp, you know, you have to go up into the forefront and know how to deal with certain individuals, communicate with certain spirits and things of that nature. And the best way and the only way you're really going to learn how to do that is being in the forefront of the battlefield, pushing this word, you know. And basically, you know, like in the time of Yahawashi, he sent out the 12 in pairs, man. You know, two and two. And that's what I have here in Mark 6 and 7. And he called unto him the 12 and began to send them forth by two and two, and gave them power over unclean spirits, and commanded them that they should take nothing for their journey save a staff only, no scrip, no bread, no money in their purse, but be sod with sandals, and not put on two coats. And he said unto them, in what place soever ye enter into an house, there abide till ye depart from that place. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear you, when ye depart thence, shake off the dust under your feet for a testimony against them. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. And they went out and preached that men should repent. And they cast out many devils and anointed with oil many that were sick and healed them.
That's right.
So, that was to build them up, man, when Yahawashi did that. You know, he endowed them with power, with the Holy Spirit, to be able to do certain functions of miracles, you know, of the working of the Spirit. You know, he didn't send them all at, you know, as a big group, the 12. He sent them out in little groups, pushing his word, prophesying, building them up, as I made mention, you know, preparing them for greater things to come after his departure, as is spoken of in the book of Acts. All right? It's like Paul and Barnabas, they were together in pairs, you know, that they weren't in big groups. If not in pairs, it was solo, man, by themselves, you know? So brothers should take heed to that, man, because there's going to come a time where that scattering of the flock is going to come all over again, as it was in the time of, you know, when Yahawashi was delivered up into the hands of the wicked, you know? His own people that delivered him unto death, all right? So the Lord is going to make things happen where it's going to end up being that way, regardless, you know, so that's something that you have to take into consideration, all right? This is in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 4, verse 9, two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow, but woe to him that is alone when he falleth, for he had not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat. But how can one be warm alone? And if one prevail against him, two shall withstand him. And a threefold cord is not quickly broken.
That's right, man. So, whether a brother's by himself, you know, two is better than one. But, you know, if a brother's by yourself, and Yahawashi, part of the elect, Yahawashi is with you. Right, but it's just a point that I wanted to bring out in the dream that I had, you know, going back, you know, a couple of years, 2 years ago, and just the elder Manasazak, you know, made that, you know, comment about, you know, breaking up, you know, that brothers in big cities that have big camps have enough men to start little camps throughout the whole city. You know, and it's true, but it's according to the Lord's will and things of that nature. But I just wanted to share that, and that one more. This is Luke chapter 22, verse 35. And he said unto them, when I sent you without purse and scrip and shoes, lack ye anything? And they said, nothing. All right. Then it says, then said he unto them, but now. He that hath a purse, let him take it, and likewise his scrip. And he that hath no sword, let him sell his garment, and buy one. For I say unto you, that this that is written must yet be accomplished in me. And he was reckoned among the transgressors, for the things concerning me have an end. And they said, Lord, behold, here are two swords. And he said unto them, it is enough. Right, so, you know, that's literal, but also when you look at it in the spiritual sense, because the scriptures say that we have to be, that iron sharpeneth iron, that we have to be sharp and quick in the spirit. All right, so I got one other scripture. Let me see if I can find it. It's in here in the book of Isaiah. Right here, Isaiah 49:2, and he has made my mouth like a sharp sword, and the shadow of his hand hath he hid me, and made me a polished shaft, and his quiver hath he hid me. See, so two is enough, man. All right, because we have to be sharp, man. We have to be ready and to be leaders, as the, you know, the elders were speaking about there in Dallas tonight, man. So you have to be kingly minded, you know, with the king mentality, rulership mentality, all right? But not to be a lord over the heritage. It's just, you got to know how to take control and leadership, all right? But that's what I wanted to bring out. Like I said, the elder made that comment, and it just brought back that dream I had 2 years ago. And, God, man, you know, hopefully, you know, brothers will be edified and things of that nature, you know, and just know that no matter how small you are, or, you know, physically, or if you're outnumbered, if Yahawashi is pleased with you, he's going to defend you, man, all right? Because the scriptures say wisdom is stronger than 10 mighty men. So this word is a powerful thing. So don't be discouraged. Keep pushing and fighting to the end. And the Lord shall fight for you unto death. All right. You know, just keep staying strong and keep pushing, man. You know, no matter what, if you're out there by yourself, you know, one man or two, three, just keep pushing, staying strong, and pleasing Yahawashi Yahawashi. That's what's going to count and profit you in the end. All right. So,